G'day, this is Julian from A&D's factory in Adelaide, Australia. Just taking this opportunity to give you an overview of a system that we've built for a local potato manufacturer. This is one of two lines and it's about to be delivered to the client next week. And it's a great example of a combination of our parent company's equipment made by A&D in Tokyo, combined with some local engineering that we add and fabricate here in Adelaide. So this is the system. The first component is a standard A&D 6 kilo checkweigher, which consists of an in-feed and away belt with a colour touchscreen HMI, and the control box, all the clever stuff, is down there underneath in the stainless steel cabinet. These are rated at IP65, so a bit of water and dust that you'd find in a typical packing shed is no problem at all. The second module here with a similar touchscreen is our 450 by 250 metal detection module. So again, you can see the circuitry and control system is in the small enclosure at the bottom, and the aperture here is the largest stock unit that we have off the shelf, and that particular one is 450 millimeters wide by 250 millimeters high. Now the conveyor deck itself takes up 20 millimeters of that aperture, as you can see there, so it means the maximum product pass height is 230 millimeters. So 230 millimeters is the biggest product we can put through here. And again, this belt is rated for 6 kilo products. So then moving on to the last section. Now this part has been built by us here in Adelaide. This is actually a dual push rejector on a stainless steel subframe. And to meet with local supermarket compliance requirements that this client has to adopt, there is a full cover. And the second of the two push rams has a fully enclosed and lockable stainless steel bin, which we've fabricated here in our factory. The first push ram, which you can see there upstream, just has an empty space. You could add another lockable bin, but the supermarket requirements, strictly speaking, are for rejecting and quarantining metal contaminated products. So a client would generally put their own bin next to that opening in the cover, and the first rejector would push it into that for either under or overweights or both if necessary. So The system also has a fail-safe for when the bin is full. You can see that red sensor there. If that sensor is tripped, there will be an alarm saying the bin's full. And then likewise, there's another fail-safe for the air pressure. So if the air pressure drops off for some reason and the rejector won't work, then another error message is triggered on the screen and the system will stop. All these push rams are guarded to make it its twofold purpose, basically for safety reasons, and also so that if another product comes through, that the shroud around the push ram will mean that the product pushes into it momentarily rather than getting caught by the push ram as it retracts. So that's the overview of the system. The only other comment on this particular one, the client needed a fairly tall line at about 1100 millimeters off the ground. Now, it's not recommended to put extension legs on an inspection system at that height. So what we've done is fabricated a stainless steel frame, which the whole system, or certainly the first two modules, sit on, as you can see there, above the ground. So just to do a quick demonstration, if we use a regular supermarket pack of potatoes, this is a 2 kilo pack. Obviously, if this one is within tolerance, it'll go through the system. As you can see, it says pass on the metal detector, and it passes straight through. And hopefully my hands are quick enough to catch it at the bottom. I'll just do that again. As you can see it going through here, it goes through the system, says pass on the metal detector, and we catch it off the end. Now, if this is underweight, I'll lift it up as it goes over the conveyor. Now it will probably be rejected here by the first reject station. Likewise, if we put a metal contaminant through, and in this case I've got a stainless steel 4 millimeter 304 stainless steel test piece, so if we put that with the sample like this, put that through with the test piece sample, that'll trigger a fail and the product gets pushed into the bin and quarantined, as you can see. We'll have a look right inside and you can
There it is.
So, that's our combination system using A&D Japan's Checkweigher and metal detector modules, and a little bit of local know-how from the crew here at A&D in Thebodon. Thanks very much for watching, and of course, if you want a demonstration of any of these systems or you want any more information, just go straight to our website. Thanks again.